go now to bed.
Directly.
Foul whisperings are abroad. Unnatural deeds do breed unnatural troubles. Infected minds will to their death pillows discharge their secrets. More needs she the divine than the physician. As this occurs, Duncan's son Malcolm has raised an army in England to retake the throne. Macduff, hearing of his family's murder, vows vengeance and joins him, and all make their way to Burnham Wood.
Great Dunsinane he strongly fortifies. Some say he's mad, others that lesser hate him do call it valiant fury. But for certain he cannot buckle his distempered cause within the belt of rule.
Now does he feel his secret murder sticking to his hands. Those he commands move only in command, nothing in love. Now does he feel his title hang loose about him.
Well, who then shall blame his pestered senses to recoil and start when all that is within him does contend itself for being there? Well, march we on to give obedience where 'tis truly owed. Meet we the medicine of the sickly wheel, and with him pour we in our country's purge each drop of us.
For so much as it needs, to dew the sovereign flower and drown the weeds.
What wood is this before us?
The wood of Burnham.
Let every soldier hew him down a bough and bear it before him.
Thereby shall we settle the number of our host and make discovery ere in report of us.
Right, shall we.
Bring me no more reports. Let them fly on. Till Burnham and their move to Dunsinane, I cannot take with fear. What's the boy Malcolm? Was he not born a woman? The spirits that know all mortal consequences have pronounced me thus. Fear not, Macbeth. No man that's born of woman shall e'er have power upon thee. Set fly, false thanes! The mind I swear by and the heart I bear shall never sag with doubt nor shake with fear. Hang out our banners on the outward walls. The cry is still, they come. Our castle's strength will laugh us each to scorn. Here let them lie till famine and the ague eat them up. Were they not forced with those that should be ours, we might have met them there for beard to beard and beat them back with horn. What is that noise?
It is the cry of women, my lord.
I have almost forgot the taste of fears. The time has been my senses would have cooled to hear a night shriek. And my fell of hair would at a dismal trees rouse and stir as life were in it. I have supped bold, boy. Direness familiar to my slaughterous thoughts cannot once start me.
The queen, my lord, is dead.
You should have died here after. Would have been a time for such a word. Tomorrow creeps in the steady pace from day to day, the last syllable of recorded time.
El mañana y el mañana avanzan en pequeños pasos de día en día hasta el último silbo del tiempo recordable.
Hasta son hasta, soste son hasta. Mainichi ga konosumasu na pesu de haisusumu.
Dumont. Supplie son si à petit pardon du holocre. Jusqu'au à le dernier, c'est le vote de transcrit.
And all our yesterdays have lighted fools away to dusty death. Ow! Ow, brief candle!
Kiero, subni, kiero, rusoku!
Et tu nous aimes, mon travailleur, les imbéciles. Les abrégés, le chemin de la mort nous dresse. Étonne-toi, Coflano!
Et todos nuestros ayeres han alumbrado a los locos. El camino así, el polvo de la muerte.
Extinguete! Extinguete, fugaz antorcha!
Life's but a walking shadow. A poor player that struts and frets his hour upon the stage and then is heard no more.
Ne vigne qu'en avant plus marche. Elle ressemble à un comédien qui sous qu'avant et s'agitait sur la théâtre en l'air. Après quoi, on n'en est plus question.
La vida no es más que una sombra que pasa. Es un pobre actor que se pavonea una hora sobre el escenario. Y después no se lo oye más. It is a tale told by an idiot, full of sound and fury. Es una historia narrada por un idiota lleno de furia y que no significa nada. Signifying nothing.
Enter the messenger. Surely he brings good news, as all messengers do in Shakespearean plays.
Thou comest to use thy tongue, thy story quickly.
I should report that which I say I saw, but know not how to do it.
Say, sir.
As I stood my watch upon the hill, I looked toward Burnham, and anon methought the wood began to move.
False upon the mysteries of thou having lied so famously. Say, till Burnham would remove the Dunsinane, and now a wood comes sword Dunsinane. For this which he avouches does appear, there is no flying hence nor tearing near. I get to be weary of the sun, and wish the estate of the world were now undone. Ring the alarm bell, blow, wind, come, rack. At least we'll die with harness on.
Oh! The time is free. I see thee encompassed in thy kingdom's pearl, that speak my salutations in their mind, whose voices I desire aloud with mine. Hail, King of Scotland!
Hail, King of Scotland!
We shall not spend a large expensive time before we reckon you with your several loves and make you even with us. My thanes and kinsmen, henceforth be earls, the first that ever Scotland in such an honor named. What's more to do than would be planted newly with the time, as calling home our